Welcome to Daily Newspaper Analysis presented by Narayana IAS Academy. Rule 293 of Rajya Sabha Procedure. Under Rule 293 of Rules of Procedure and Conduct of Business in the Council of States, members of Rajya Sabha are required to furnish declaration regarding five pecuniary interests. These five pecuniary interests would be remunerative directorship, regular remunerated activity, shareholding of controlling nature, paid consultancy and professional engagement. The rules say that a member should not participate in any debate if there is direct conflict of interest without first declaring it, and that in case of vote on any issue in the House, the vote of such a member could be challenged. This is in the news because Committee on Ethics is discussing Rule 293 of Rajya Sabha. Sensex falls. The bears, that is the selling, continues to tighten their grip on the market. The BSE Sensex and the NSE Nifty both opened to heavy losses. Below are some of the factors that are spurring on market volatility. Fall in the rupee, which has fallen from 68 to 74 per $1. Surging oil prices, which has risen from $70 per barrel to $84 to $85 per barrel. Raising bond yields, foreign capital outflows, and highly fragile investor sentiment. IORA Delhi Declaration. The Indian Ocean Rim Association is an international organization consisting of coastal states bordering the Indian Ocean. The IORA is a regional forum, tripartite in nature, bringing together representatives of government, business and academia for promoting cooperation and close interaction among them. It is based on the principles of open regionalism for strengthening economic cooperation, particularly on trade facilitation and investment promotion, as well as social development of the region. The coordinating secretariat of IORA is located in Mauritius. These are the countries in the map which you can see are the members of IORA. Significant members who are not part of IORA are Saudi Arabia, Myanmar, Pakistan, Somalia. Except them, all the major countries on the Indian Ocean Rim, including Iran, Oman, Yemen, Thailand, Malaysia, Indonesia, Sri Lanka, Maldives, Mauritius, Madagascar, Comoros and Seychelles are members. Delhi Declaration on Renewable Energy in Indian Ocean Region. It calls for collaboration among IORA member states in meeting the growing demand for renewable energy in Indian Ocean littorals. The declaration also calls for promotion of technology development and transfer, strengthening of PPP in renewable energy, and collaboration among IORA members and International Solar Alliance for exchange of knowledge and potential interest. Additionally, IORA member nations and IRENA will undertake expansion of Global Renewable Energy Atlas. That is, Global Renewable Energy Atlas is created by IRENA, the world's largest ever joint renewable resource data project, coordinated by IRENA, thereby creating the Indian Ocean region's first and most comprehensive map and database, which can then be used to tap the sizable renewable energy potential of the region. GI tag from Alfonso Mangoes from Konkan region. Alfonso Mangoes from Ratnagiri, Sindhudurg, Palghar, Thane and Raigarh district of Maharashtra is registered as a got geographical indicator tag. A GI indicator or a GI is an indicator used on products that have specific geographical origin and possesses quality or reputation that are due to that origin. Such a name conveys an assurance of quality and distinctiveness, which is essentially attributable to its source. Operation Samudra Maitri. India has launched massive humanitarian operation Samudra Maitri to provide assistance to earthquake and tsunami victims of Indonesia. Under this operation, India has dispatched two aircrafts, C-130J and C-17, and three naval ships carrying relief material and personnel to the country. Saudi Arabia to invest in Gwadar. Saudi Arabia will invest in a new oil refinery in Pakistan's growing deep sea port of Gwadar. Gwadar port is developed as a part of 60 billion China-Pakistan economic corridor. Gwadar is a part of Pakistan's mineral is southwestern Balochistan province. Rohingya deportation. Rohingyas are an ethnic group, mostly Muslims, who are based in Rakhine province of West Myanmar. Myanmar has not granted them full citizenship and they are classified as resident foreigners or associate citizens. They speak a dialect of Bengali and not Burmese. They left Myanmar in large numbers, first in 2012 during the first wave of organized attacks against them by the army. How many Rohingyas are there in India? The Home Ministry told the Parliament that there are around 40,000 Rohingyas in India, of which around 5,700 are in Jammu. Of them, 16,000 are said to be registered with United Nations. Now, 7 of these Rohingyas are said to be deported. What is the process of deportation? There are no separate rules for Rohingyas. All illegal immigrants are detected, detained, and deported under the provisions of Passport Act 1920 or Foreigners Act 1946. The powers to identify and deport them have been delegated to state governments, union territories. Once the foreigner has been apprehended by the police for staying here illegally without any documents, he or she is produced before a local court. The court, after hearing the police and alleged foreigner, examines the case. If the accused are found guilty, they can be imprisoned and deported. Was the deportation of 7 Rohingyas on Thursday first instance? While the deportation of foreigners staying illegally have taken place earlier, this is the first time Myanmar has accepted Rohingya and issued them a certificate of identity 2 months ago. The 7 persons were caught in 2012 in Assam. They were moved to detention center from prison and they wrote to Myanmar embassy in 2016 expressing their desire to return to their country. The process of establishing their identity was started then. As we have seen earlier, these foreigners who have illegally stayed are first sentenced up to 3 years to 8 years. What happens after the completion of the sentence? Once the accused have completed the jail sentence, the court orders their deportation and they are moved to detention centers till the country of their origin verifies and accepts them. The state government writes to the country concerned and the consular access is provided to the detainees. In the case of this Rohingya deportation, the Assamese government has made arrangements for their repatriation through an immigration checkpoint in Manipur called Morey. Thank you.